Hello, my name is Tolu Olubumi, and I am here in Geneva at the UN Migration Agency's annual meeting. This is where the governing body of the UN Migration Agency, its countries that are invested in its work and helps to lead its work, come together to talk about the most pressing issues facing the organization. Now, throughout this council, one of the biggest things that I've heard talked about is climate. I wasn't exactly sure exactly what climate and migration had to do with each other, so I found the woman who knows exactly what that means, Dina Ionesco. You head a division that is focused on the connection between climate and migration. Can you tell us exactly what that is and what is that connection?
Thank you so much, and thank you for a wonderful introduction about the importance of climate in the context of migration. So, indeed, IOM has really invested a lot to bring awareness of the importance of climate change and also environmental degradation in the migration debate and migration policy and practice. And indeed, there are two different worlds coming here together, and it takes also a while to find a common language between the community of people speaking about changes in the environment and the community speaking about human mobility. And in IOM, through the work of the division that we created in 2015 that connects issues of migration, environment, and climate change, we try to really bring to the light the importance of environmental drivers of migration and the importance of the impacts of migration on the environment.
Interesting. So this is basically about people moving because of climate change?
So it's a very, very complex topic. So it's not it's very difficult to say there's a causality, climate change equals migration. Okay. It's much more complicated because migration doesn't work this way. Migration is also a personal strategy, a collective also endeavor. What we see is that environmental drivers, so you can imagine storms, floods, but also very slow degradation, desertification, sea level rise, loss of ecosystems, are drivers of migration, and increasingly so. But very often, they are connected to other issues, conflict, labor issues, jobs. You lose your job, but then you realize it's maybe related to a big drought.
Oh, wow. So there's a famine or a drought, the jobs go away, people migrate. So it's all interconnected.
Yes, and migration, it's one of the possible responses. So that's why it's not so simple, because you can have important, for instance, drought or desertification, and people don't even have the means to move out. So they very often would remain, in fact, trapped. And because they are at risk, it doesn't mean that these people will migrate. And then I think also, what do we mean by migration? There's also a lot of different notions there that are behind this word. You have internal migration, you have international migration, you have people being forced to move, you have people who decide to move. So we have to look at all these nuances, and that's what we try to do with the organization and with a very broad network of partners.
That's incredible. Now, I know that there is a conference coming up next week in Poland on climate. Is climate and migration going to be an important topic at that conference?
I think yes, now it will be. So we had 16 years of climate discussion and negotiation where there was nothing on human mobility. And for the past years, we saw this awareness about the importance of the way people respond to climate change, also through migration, growing in the agenda. And next climate conference that is in Poland will have a whole part of its work devoted to human mobility, because the Paris Agreement has tasked, for instance, a task force to work on providing recommendation to states on how to address and minimize and also to respond and even prevent, avert the negative impacts of climate change on human mobility. So this will all be part of the main discussion at the climate conference. What is also interesting is to say is that a lot has moved on the climate side, but now we are moving also on the migration side in terms of awareness.
Incredible. Well, from the Director General of IOM to the Secretary General of the UN to countries across the globe, climate is a major topic, and now climate migration is becoming more and more important for them to talk about. Thank you so much, Dina, for taking the time to break this down for us. Thank you all so much for watching, and we will see you again soon.